Hi, I'm Don with AWS.
Hi, I'm Britt with First Orion, and this is my architecture.
So Britt, I'm excited to talk about your architecture. I see Amazon Q. Generative AI is top of mind for all of our customers. So really excited to hear more about how you've used Amazon Q.
Yeah, so at First Orion, we're ultimately a data company, but we specialize in telecom software. We make it safe to answer your phone again. So as someone who came from the cloud operations, a lot of stuff requires troubleshooting. Well, a lot of your data is tied up in these silos across these different services, and you have to take time out and go and look at that instead of working on a problem. You're just trying to chase details down. Mm-hmm. So as someone like some cloud operations, they would come in to Identity Center. Mm-hmm. Between Q and Identity Center is a web experience. They allow you to create an app. Q allows you to create an app and publish it on Identity Center. So you have a Q app. The user comes in, authenticates, talks to the Q app, and by talking, I mean they're talking to their data now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, now that's definitely an interesting perspective. So they're chatting with their data. You have a lot of data sources here, right? So we got S3 and web crawlers and an application, Confluent. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about that experience for the cloud operator.
Yeah, so you can think of Q as kind of like the hub in a wheel, right? And it spokes out from there, so it can go to S3. Maybe you put some PDFs in there, right? Maybe you need to be able to crawl the web and you don't exactly know where it's gonna be, so you've told Q, hey, go out and look at these certain domains and go 2, 3, 5 deep. Okay. If you come across a link, pull that information too. Confluence is a service that allows you to have knowledge base articles, blogs, that type of thing, but that requires you to go and read it.
Got it.
Right? Q reads it for you. It's hit all the internet. It's hit Confluence. Brought all that stuff into Q. So in your Q app, your user is asking those questions. Q is providing those answers because it's crawled it and indexed it for you.
Okay. So couple of things. One is the integration with those data sources. Oftentimes you're going to go find the person who owns it to get connectivity, right? So you simplified that. And then you've also simplified it for the user. They're just using natural language questions, prompting, if you will, the LLM, and they have their answer.
That's it.
So I'm interested now in just diving a little deeper on this CMDB here. I'm definitely interested in learning more about that.
Right. So AWS provides a service called Config, which takes a state, a snapshot of the current state of resources. There's a connector between ServiceNow and AWS. Mm-hmm. We use ServiceNow as our CMDB. So it's kind of, in a way, you're querying AWS config with Q, but you're doing it through your CMDB, right? So it's just another spoke going out. Q is just making spoke connections.
Now, can I also, you know, if I'm a different user coming in, can I, for example, create a ticket in ServiceNow or even Zendesk?
Right, so this user needs to come in just like normal, comes into Identity Center, hits the app, and starts asking questions. The cool thing is Q has plugins. These are an enhancement, just like guardrails and some other things within Q. Instead of just reading, right? Instead of Q coming down and just reading what's in Jira and Zendesk and Salesforce, you can actually come in and then ask it to create a case for you. So if you're receiving some type of error and you're saying, well, now I got to get out, go to this other service, and write a ticket. In Q, you can just say, create a ticket in Jira. A window's going to pop up. You're going to fill in whatever you need, hit submit. There's now a ticket in Jira, and you're ready to keep moving on and troubleshooting.
Great. So couple of things there. One is the friction has been removed, interacting with those separate external systems, but also now I could receive an email or I could have an additional flow within that application.
Yeah, because normally when you open a ticket in these, you're gonna get a response. You're gonna get a response when you submit the ticket saying a ticket's been created.
Right.
And then you're gonna get a follow-up email from within that system itself telling you ticket number XYZ has been created. And it'll show you everything that it normally does, like this is what the ticket's for.
So that's impressive. With respect to Q, oftentimes we get the comparison. So do I need to go with Bedrock or Amazon Q? I'd like to learn about your trade-offs and journey there.
Yeah, so when first coming up with this idea, you're thinking, well, Bedrock's a a slightly bigger lift just because you have to figure out which foundation model you're going to use. You're going to have to tune that foundation model, which in certain instances, you want to be able to do that. Mm-hmm. But for something simple, as in just, I want to talk to my data, it doesn't get much simpler than Q. And Q does provide a lot of the same things that Bedrock does in guardrails so that, you know, a person should only be able to see what they're authorized to see. And so you're able to do all that within Q.
Well, thank you, Britt. I really appreciate you sharing this architecture and talking about Amazon Q, the data sources and the plugins and the benefits to you as a company.
Oh, that was great. Yeah, appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you.